guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm just going to be sharing with you a few tips and tricks that I do to help me keep a budget on my keto lifestyle. So we're just going to jump right on into it, guys, with number one, and that is eggs and bacon. Now, eggs and bacon are a staple for me. I always have them every morning. It fills me up and it's just really, really delicious. You can have eggs for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. It just depends on you and how you feel that day. And bacon, I like bacon because it's got a dual purpose. One, you can have the bacon for a meal or a snack. And two, you can render the fat from the bacon and you can add that into your meals or cook meals with it. And it's just going to add in healthy fats into your meals. And number two is takeout. When I say takeout, I don't say eliminate it completely, but I would say limit yourself with takeout. Now, me personally, I don't eat takeout that often because I can make it at home. I can make the exact same meal at home, but keto friendly, and it's just as good. But I will give myself a cheat day where I can just enjoy a meal with my family and I don't feel deprived. So I will have a cheat meal every once in a while. It just depends. I haven't had a cheat meal in a few months, actually, so that's good. So takeout is going to be a big budget breaker if you are on a budget. And number three is to buy things on sale at your local grocery store. Now, you can just check with your local grocery store and see what they have in their bulk section. Now, you can buy things at Sam's, Costco, Trader Joe's, Walmart, or just a local grocery store like Aldi's or something like that. They all have a bulk section depending on your grocery store. So just go in there and see what they have in their bulk section and buy from there. Not only is it going to save you money, it's going to help you in your meal preps and everything like that. And it's going to help you stay on track in the keto lifestyle. And number four is to meal prep. Now, you don't have to go and completely meal prep complete meals if you don't want to. You can just meal prep certain items, so that way if you want something, you can just pull it out and you can just heat it up. Like for me, I will meal prep bacon or chicken, or sometimes I'll meal prep ground beef. It just depends on what I'm feeling that day and how much time I have in the day to meal prep. And it's going to save you so much money because you're not going to end up going to the store every day to buy this or to buy that. It's going to help you in a sense that you can just pull it out of your refrigerator and it's easy and convenient for you. And this goes along with number five, and it is to cook your meals in bulk. You can do things like meal prep ground beef for the week or chicken for the week. You can do bacon. You can just cook the bacon, pop it in the freezer and put your grease in a mason jar and put that in the refrigerator. Or you can do things like chilies or casseroles or soups and just cook those and let them cool down, have them, and then store them in the freezer. Whichever one that you like, it's going to help you save money. And not only that, you can get two meals for the price of one. This also goes along with number six, and that is to buy items in bulk. You can go to Sam's, Costco, Trader Joe's, which I don't have a Trader Joe's anywhere near me, but if I did, I would surely go there and shop because they have some awesome stuff. You can go and buy stuff in bulk at Walmart or Aldi, whichever store that you have nearest to you. Just see what they have in their bulk section and buy from there, and it's going to save you a lot of money and you're going to get a lot more bang for your buck. And number seven is you do not have to buy brand name items. I hardly buy brand name items, and that's because the generic brand, they have the exact same ingredients, the exact same macros, and they taste exactly the same. Now, there are some stuff that I do buy name brand, and that's just personal preference, but you do you. But buying generic is going to, one, save you money, and it's not going to taste any different at all. And yeah, you guys, so buying in generic brands, just make sure you read the label and make sure they are keto friendly. And number eight is you do not have to spend loads and loads of money on organic, grass-fed or grass-finished beef, chicken, pork, or grain-fed chicken eggs, or anything like that. You don't have to buy those things. Yes, they are good. Yes, I'm sure if you could budget that into your keto budget for the month, by all means, go ahead and buy those. But for people who are on a budget and can't afford $12 a carton for eggs or $20 a pound for grass-fed, grass-finished beef, don't worry about it. Just buy regular ground beef, regular pork, regular chicken, and buy your eggs in bulk. It's going to last you the whole month, and they taste the same, and you get the exact same nutrition from those items. So I really wouldn't stress about buying organic anything or grass-fed, grass-finished anything just because somebody else buys it for their keto lifestyle. If you can't afford it, don't worry with it. It's not a problem. I've not noticed any difference in buying grass-fed or organic anything, or just the $5 ground beef or $5 pork chops at the grocery store. I've not noticed a difference, and I've lost weight both ways. So it really just depends on you and your budget. And another thing that is expensive is pre-packaged items like sweets or pre-packaged meals or anything like that. I wouldn't worry so much with that. If you can afford it or if you can put it into your budget within the month, by all means, go ahead and do that. Me personally, I love the Quest bars, so I budget them into my monthly budget. But when I do this, I make sure that it lasts me all month long, so that way I only buy them once a month and I can portion them out for me and my lifestyle. So that way it saves me loads and loads of money, because if you're constantly buying prepackaged meals, keto meals, or prepackaged keto sweets, it's going to get expensive very, very quickly. So just keep that in mind, and if you can splurge on a prepackaged sweets or anything like that, by all means, go ahead and do that. So it just depends on you and your budget. And also, if you're really wanting something sweet, there are so many recipes out there that you can get from YouTube, or you can get from Pinterest, or recipe books or anything like that, and you can make them at home, and it's going to save you so much time and so much money. It is awesome, because you pretty much, if you're on keto, you pretty much have the ingredients there to make it anyway, so it's going to save you a load of money. So look into just making them at home, and plus they're better for you and they don't have all those preservatives or anything in there that's that keeps it shelf stable. So you can just make it at home, pop it in the refrigerator, pull it out whenever you need it. And another thing is to buy frozen vegetables and frozen fruits that are in season. Now, Every grocery store has a frozen fruit section and a frozen vegetable section. So you can always look there and buy keto-friendly vegetables and berries. Now, when you buy fresh stuff, I try to buy seasonally keto-friendly fruits and vegetables because they're cheaper. If you buy out of season and they're not frozen, you're going to spend so much money. It is ridiculous. I've spent more money buying fresh vegetables and fruit than I have buying frozen vegetables and fruit. So keep that in mind when you buy vegetables or fruits. Buy seasonally and it's going to be so much cheaper. If you don't want to buy fresh fruits or vegetables, go to the freezer section and check out the keto-friendly vegetables and fruits that they have in their store. And just buy those. I love broccoli and Brussels sprouts and okra and stuff like that. So my freezer is always stocked with frozen vegetables. I buy strawberries and blueberries. Sometimes I'll buy blackberries and I keep them in the freezer. And they will last me 2 to 3 months. So it just depends on you and your budget, but those are a few tips for vegetables and fruit. If you have fruit in your keto lifestyle, I would definitely look into buying the frozen fruit. It's just going to save you money and it's going to save you, you know, it's going to last a long time in your freezer because you're just pulling out just a few pieces and you're good to go. So, yeah, you guys, that is what I would do if I was, you know, if when I buy vegetables and fruit, I either buy seasonally or I buy frozen. So, it's just going to save you so much money in the long run. So, I hope those tips and tricks helped you out just a little bit. If there are any tips or tricks that you do for your keto lifestyle that help you on your budget, let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear what you do, and maybe I can implement that into my keto lifestyle as well. So yeah, leave a comment in the comment section down below, and we're just going to get right on into the 3 keto-friendly meals. I'm going to show you a breakfast, lunch, and dinner. They're so easy to make and they're very, very budget friendly and they taste so good. So let's just jump right on into that and I will show you breakfast and then I'll show you my lunch and then I will show you a really, really good budget friendly keto dinner. All right, guys, our first budget friendly meal is breakfast, and you can never go wrong with bacon and eggs. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a little bacon grease in our pan and we're going to let that heat up, and then we're just going to cook 2 eggs. Meanwhile, I'm going to heat up 2 pieces of bacon in the microwave and call it a meal. You can cook these eggs however you like. Today I'm just going to fry them. And that's how I usually have them, but sometimes I will have a scrambled eggs or an omelet. It just depends on how I'm feeling that day. So, like I said before, bacon and eggs are a great budget-friendly, keto-friendly meal. Guys, first thing is first, you're gonna need a bowl. Now we're going to be making an egg salad, and this is something that I love to have for lunch. It's just easy. It's so easy to make and it fills you up. It's got a lot of good healthy fats in there and it's just really delicious. So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to get 2 eggs. Now you can do 1 or you can do 2. It just depends on whatever you feel that day. And then you're just going to pretty much just break these up. If you have one of those fancy dancy egg choppers, you can go ahead and use that. Or you can take the time and chop it up with a knife. I'm just going to squish these little babies just like this. It's all going to turn out the same anyway. So just go ahead and squish these to whatever consistency that you like. You can also meal prep this too. You can go ahead and just make a big batch of this and keep this in the refrigerator. And just pull out whatever amount that you like. It's completely up to you. I do that sometimes, but today I'm just going to show you how I make it. It's very, very simple. So now that you've got your egg all nice and squished, you're just going to add in about 2 tablespoons of mayo. Now, you can use whatever mayo that you like. I use the Duke's brand. It has no sugar in there, but it does have a soybean oil in it, which is inflammatory. So if you don't want to use that, by all means, there are so many other keto-friendly mayo out there that you can use. This is just what I prefer. Now, you're just going to add in about a tablespoon of bacon bits. Now, you don't have to put these in there, but I just like the flavor of them. This is the one that I have. Next, I'm just going to add in about a tablespoon of cheese. You can do whatever cheese that you like. It's completely up to you. Now I'm just going to add in just a little bit of salt. I like to use pink Himalayan salt, but you can use whatever that you like. It's up to you. And then I'm just going to add in just a little bit of pepper. And then you're just going to give this a mix. Now at this point, you can taste it and see if it needs more salt or pepper. Sometimes I add a little bit of hot sauce in here just to give it a little kick. But today I'm just going to leave it plain. I'm also going to be pairing it with these. These are the Great Value Blue Cheese Stuffed Green Olives. And you guys, they are so delicious. If you have not tried those, I really, really suggest you do. They are absolutely fantastic. I'm just going to scoop out about 6 of these. They are so, so good, and I highly recommend these, especially if you love blue cheese and olives. I would pick those up. They're very, very budget friendly. So guys, this is what I'm going to have for lunch. I will see you guys back in just a little bit, and we will be making some dinner. So I'm just going to go eat this, and I will see you guys in just a few minutes. All right, guys, for our next budget-friendly meal, we're just going to be having buffalo-style meatballs and roasted broccoli. We're going to start out by 1 pound of ground beef in a bowl. You're going to add in 2 teaspoons of parsley flakes, 1 teaspoon of onion powder, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, salt and pepper to taste. Then we're going to add in 1 tablespoon of Frank's Red Hot hot sauce. And then we're just going to mix that up. Next, I'm just going to use a small ice cream scoop, and I'm going to just scoop out little balls of ground beef and place that on my tray. Then we're just going to pop these in the oven at 425 for 15 to 20 minutes, just until they are completely cooked through. Then you can remove these and place them in a bowl. And then you're going to add in about a quarter of a cup of Frank's Red Hot hot sauce to your meatballs. And then you're just going to add in 1 tablespoon of butter and just give them a toss, and they are done. And I paired these with broccoli. And that's going to be it, you guys. I hope this video inspired you, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Hit that little red subscribe button down below, and don't forget to tick that notification bell so you'll be part of the family here and won't miss out on any videos. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.